Hi students, today we will discuss about the role of a teacher in forming clear concepts in students. The session outline is role of a teacher. At the end of this module, you will be able to discuss the role of a teacher as per Ossebel's theory of meaningful verbal learning. Prior knowledge is crucial to teach more about a particular phenomenon. Therefore, the first thing which teacher should realize is link the present knowledge to the relevant past knowledge. So, we'll have to ask questions related to the previous knowledge or tell them some anecdote or analogy related to the topic which we have to teach, just to see that there is relevant previous knowledge that exists about the topic which we have to teach. Teacher's role lies in giving appropriate organizers. We see the textbooks make use of this phenomenon. Whenever we have to learn about states of matter, we find flow charts or classifying tables for comparing elements, mixtures and compounds, chemical reactions and physical reactions and so on. And when we have to learn about different cells and their functions, we may use a circular graphic organizer in which we can mention, we can put the cell in the center and the different organs and their functions can be explained by bringing in circles around the main one. And if you want to explain a procedure, we can use this flow chart starting from the first step to the subsequent ones. And whenever a concept is involved, then we can make use of concepts to explain a particular concept graphically, starting with the main concept and indicating hierarchically the sub-concepts coming down and using even the linking words to show the relation between the main concept and the sub-concept. So the variety of graphic organizers are available on the websites and the teacher can be making use of this wisely so as to bring in a concrete visual representation of whatever is being taught, which enables students to analyze, classify and even synthesize the information so as to make their concepts clear. Once we introduce the advanced organizers, then our role will be to present that learning material in an organized and structured manner. What does that mean? We will have to classify so as to make it more comprehensible and enable students to assimilate that information. For example, while teaching about natural numbers or whole numbers, we can always classify them into odd numbers and even numbers. When you have to teach the students about the states of matter, we can always classify them into elements, mixtures and compounds. When you have to teach about living beings, we can always classify them into animals and plants. And when you have to teach about plants, we can again classify them into terrestrial plants and aquatic plants and so on. So, classification is one of the methods by which we can organize the information. And when we say structured information, the information presented in the form of a graphic organizer or a flow chart or a concept map in which the all-inclusive general concepts come at the top, and as and when we come down in that chart, the more specific concepts will be emerging. So, moving from general to particular will be involved in the structuring of the information. One more method of making the concepts clear would be to use the teaching aids for cross-referring old and new ideas. For example, students might have already learnt about eclipse. They might have already learnt about solar system. And you are teaching them suddenly about certain phenomena which are occurring at present, or maybe you are teaching about meteorites or asteroids or whatever, then we may have to refer again to whatever they have learnt, and it would be easier for them to recollect and have an idea about it if you are to bring in concrete pictures or teaching aids or movies and then make a reference to that and explain more about it in detail. So that will enable them to connect the present knowledge to the one which they have already learnt. it is always necessary for a teacher to get feedback towards the end regarding the understanding of the concepts by the students. How can we do that in reception learning? We see that in most of the classes, the students will be completely silent and the teacher goes on and on describing, explaining, comparing. Towards the end, the teacher can always give some examples or even seek examples from the students which show that they have understood the concepts. For example, when you are teaching about simple machines, you can towards the end give the example of a sewing machine and ask them to say which are the different simple machines which are involved in that, or even you can ask them to mention the type of simple machine which is involved in a crane or in the hospitals when they lift heavy weights, and even in the factories when the heavy weights are lifted, and in motor vehicles and so on. So it is very necessary for us to see that the students apply their textual knowledge to daily life phenomena to assimilate the information and to see that the concepts are clear. We must use concept maps and other graphic organizers. Only difference in the mind maps and concept maps is that, as you see in this diagram, if you have to put the idea in the center and then write all related terms around it, that becomes a mind map. But if you have to take the idea at the top of the map and then connect to it the sub concepts and then use a linking word, then it becomes a concept map. In detail, if you want to know about it, you can refer to the Google and then try to read more about it. But using graphic organizers always gives a visual representation of whatever the students are learning, and it also shows